Hello world, it's Rahul. Welcome back guys to deep learning tutorial. So guys, today we are going to discuss what is activation function and how can we use different activation functions at different places. After completing this tutorial, you will know that first, sigmoid and hyperbolic tangent activation functions cannot be used in networks with many layers due to the vanishing gradient problem. And second, leaky ReLU function overcomes the vanishing gradient problem, allowing models to learn faster and perform better. So guys, watch this video till end for understanding this particular thing, as I'm going to explain you about each and every aspects of activation function. Let's understand what is activation function. So guys, if you remember my last video on neural network, then we had a neuron as shown on the screen, and this particular neuron is getting some of the input signals, which is nothing but the different features. And these input signals are multiplied by some weight matrix so that each signal differs from one another. Now, if I take summation of all incoming input signal multiplied by weights and add a bias term to this, then we pass it to an activation function and then move forward to next hidden layer. So guys, here we will not discuss about bias, because if I'll go to the bias, then backpropagation will come into picture. But you need not to worry, as I will come up with bias and weight matrix in my upcoming videos. Okay, so once we got this, activation function activates or deactivates neuron. That's it. If neuron is activated, then output is provided to next layer. Otherwise, that particular neuron does not participate for next layer. So when I say activation function activates the neuron, that means if weighted sum of incoming signal is more than some specified threshold, then only it activates neuron. So now we can say that activation function decides whether a neuron should be activated or not, whether the information that the neuron is receiving is relevant for the given information or should it be ignored. So guys, we have two types of activation function. One is linear and other is non-linear activation function. So we already know that linear functions are the equation which graph a straight line in an xy plane. So the output of the function will not be confined between any range. Whereas non-linear function means the graph is not a straight line. Instead, it is a curved line or some range. So guys, non-linear function further divided into six parts, and that is threshold function, sigmoid or logistic function, hyperbolic tangent activation function, also known as TANH, then rectified linear unit known as ReLU, leaky ReLU, and softmax function. Let's discuss all of them one by one. Let's start with threshold activation function. So guys, if value of y is greater than or equal to 0, which is weighted sum, then it will represent it as 1. If y is lesser than 0, then it will represent it as 0. So this type of activation function is used where we have to just classify element either as 1 or 0. So you can see graphical representation of what I have just explained you. Here, value above than 1 considered as 1 and value less than 0 as 0. Now why is this 0 and 1 required, or why is this activation function is required? Okay, let's say accidentally I touch a nail. So neuron at my hand gets activated due to that particular nail and send a signal to brain, then only I'll be able to understand that I have touched nail which can hurt me, and then I can respond to that particular stimuli and move my hand back. So for that, you know, activation function and weights are important. So if we get 1, then that particular neuron will get activated, otherwise it will deactivate. Now let's move into sigmoid activation function. So guys, if you can see on the screen, graph for sigmoid function looks like S-shaped. So basically, it reduces extreme values or outliers in data without actually removing them from data. So formula for sigmoid is shown on the screen, which is nothing but 1 divided by 1 plus e to the power minus y. And here y is summation of weights multiplied by x plus bias. So here, what sigmoid function does is, let this product be any value either negative or positive. Whenever we replace this in formula, it ranges the independent variable between 0 and 1. So here question is, how can we assign any value as either 0 or 1? So it's very simple. We decide some threshold over the graph. Let's say I draw a threshold of 0.5, and whenever it is greater than 0.5, output is considered as 1, and when it is less than 0.5, then output will be considered as 0. So guys, from this you can understand that how it reduces the outliers or extreme values. One more thing guys, we call this function as logistic function because we are dealing with 0 and 1 value, and we are finding the output probabilities by the same mean we were using during the time of logistic regression. So if you don't have any intuition about logistic regression, then please go and watch my logistic regression video. Those who are following my sessions definitely know that I've already uploaded these videos into machine learning tutorial playlist. You can find out the link as well into description. Alright guys, let's discuss hyperbolic tangent activation function, which is also known as tanh activation function. Unlike the sigmoid function, the range for tanh function is minus 1 to 1. So it is similar to sigmoid function, where we were catering the output in a range of 0 and 1 and setting up the threshold at 0.5. So in tanh, we extend the lower side of the curve till negative 1, and our mid will be at 0. So guys, by definition, tanh function is derived from the trigonometric function. That's why its formula is written as tan hyperbolic of h equal to sine hyperbolic of h divided by cos hyperbolic of x. A general problem with both sigmoid and tanh function is that they saturate. This means that the large values snap to 1 and small values snap to minus 1 or 0 for tanh and sigmoid respectively. So guys, now coming to rectified linear unit or ReLU function, as name suggests, it acts like a linear function but is in fact a non-linear function, allowing the complex relationship in data to be learned. So just like we were passing the weighted sum of input signal plus bias in case of sigmoid function, if we pass the same to ReLU function, then according to the formula used for ReLU, that is max of 0, y. So what does it mean is, if our y is weighted sum of input plus bias and this value is coming as some positive value, then the max of 0 and that particular positive value would be that value itself. But what if our y is some negative value? Then max of that negative value and 0 would be 0 only. So by same intuition, we can draw a graphical representation of ReLU function as shown on the screen. So guys, for y is equal to 0 or any negative value, our output will be transformed to 0. But it increases with the same y value if y is greater than 0. Let's say y is 2, then the output will be 2. If y is 4, then the output will be 4. So guys, this is very powerful activation function, as this is used at most of the places in deep learning. So guys, we will understand in upcoming sessions that where can we use ReLU function or any other function. So just to give you a heads up, for most of the classification problems, we use sigmoid function at the last layer because we want to classify the output between 0 and 1. But if we are solving any regression problem, then mostly we use ReLU function, let it be in any hidden layer or output layer. Let's get back to the graph again. So guys, you can see for any negative value or 0, our output is considered as 0. It means we are not activating those neurons. But for positive value, our neuron strength is progressing exactly in the same way what value of y we are getting. Let's say if we are getting positive infinite value for y, then in that case, our output would be positive infinity. And for negative value, our output will be 0. So once we have the output value with us, we basically backpropagate the derivative of output value with respect to term x for adjusting the weight matrix. As I've already told you guys in my last video, that we have to adjust weight matrix for getting the correct output. I will not go into deep of this backpropagation because this is really a great topic to explain. I will upload a separate video on this topic. Here I'm just giving you a basic intuition so that you guys can understand the problem we are facing when ReLU function is applying to weighted sum of input signals. Let's understand how can we backpropagate the output. So if you can see on the screen, this is how our graph looks like for ReLU function. Now, if I want to find the derivative of this particular line, then the value will always be 1, because this line is at an angle of 45 degree. And we all know that 1045 degree is 1. So for this line, I can draw a straight line at 1. Now, for any positive value, derivative of our output would always be 1. Now for negative side, you can see that this is just a constant value at 0th axis. So according to derivative rule, derivative of constant value will be 0. So for any 0 or negative value, derivative will be marked as 0. So range of derivative of value function will be 0 for negative value and 1 for value greater than 0. Guys, now you must have one doubt that how is this different from sigmoid function, as sigmoid was also ranging between 0 and 1. So in sigmoid, the derivative will always ranges between 0 to 0.5 and in tanh, it is always less than 1. Now let's apply derivative value in updation formula. So we have this formula, y old is equal to y new minus learning rate into derivative of loss with respect to derivative of w. Let's say we have two derivatives and it's a chain rule. So we will consider both 1 and 0 scenario. First, let's put 1 for this derivative. So learning rate will be multiplied by 1 and it got subtracted from the y new value. Till now, everything is fine. But what if we consider derivative of output as 0? Let's quickly see that. So here, put derivatives as 0. And when we multiply this with learning rate, that will become 0 only. Now if you'll see, y old is equal to y new, as remaining term becomes 0. So it is acting like a dead neuron, as we are not updating anything and still we have activated this neuron, which is of no use. So guys, this is the main problem with ReLU activation function, which is also known as vanishing gradient. So guys, for fixing this problem, we have one concept, and that is leaky ReLU function. On the same note, let's understand leaky ReLU function, as this is an improvement to ReLU function. Now let's see, how can we fix our problem? So here we will try to add some value to constant side. That means line will not be exactly 0 for negative number. Instead, it will be some addition to this value. So here, if y is greater than 0, then output would be y itself. But if y is less than 0, then instead of putting it as 0, we will add some value to 0. Let's say we take 0.01. and this will be multiplied by x. Now, if we find the derivative of this term, that is 0.01 into y divided by derivative of w, then our output will be some 0.01 value, but not 0. And if we subtract this value from y new, then we will get some value which we can use for updation. So by this way, we have solved dead neuron problem by just simply adding some value to negative side. So guys, now we only have to discuss softmax activation function. Let's see what softmax activation function states. So it is a mathematical function that converts a vector of number into a vector of probabilities, where the probabilities of each values are proportional to the relative scale of each value in the vector. Let's say we have multi-class classification problem, then we apply softmax function so that it will give us relevance probabilities for each class. Let's say we have three classes, A, B and C. Now we have created neural network and then we have applied this activation function at last layer for getting the output. So we will get the output in terms of probability matrix as shown on the screen. Class A with probability of 0.25, class B with probability of 0.12 and then class C with probability of 0.63. So according to this result, our prediction would be class C, as it is showing the highest relevance probability for this particular class. Now again, range for this will be 0 to 1 only, as we can see in the example what I've just shared with you. So guys, this is all about activation function and its type. Hope you guys understand each segment of this video. Guys, this is just a basic intuition of activation function. We will see how can we use these activation functions in upcoming videos. Thank you guys for your time. Do like, share and subscribe. Hit the bell icon to get the latest updates. Happy learning and stay safe.